Welcome friends to One Stop Java Solutions. I am Sneasis and today I am going to solve TCS Proctored assessment of 25th January. Okay. So in previous video, I have already solved the first two part. Okay. Of this question 2. Here you can see. We go to Eclipse. So here you can see I have already implemented the main method, okay, and also the inventory class. Okay, so now I have to implement the replenish. This method, replenish method. So here, okay, so what you have to do, just read this part, implement a static method replenish in solution class. This method will take an int parameter named limit. So this part is done. This method will return array of inventory where the threshold attribute is less than or equal to the int parameter passed. So int limit I have already sent to this method. Okay, so you have to implement this method. Okay, so for that, whatever I got here, an array, inventory array. Okay, so and size of the array is 4. Okay, so here I am writing a for loop, int I equal to 0, I less than 4, because it the size of the array is 4, and I plus plus. Okay. And inside that array, what I will check, that the if arri dot, I have to check the threshold value. Okay, so for that I call the get threshold. Okay, get threshold method, and it will give the threshold value if it is less than equal to limit. Okay, limit I have already passed to this method, so I will check if this less than limit, then what I will do, then I will store this value into, I am not taking any other inventory, I am storing in this array only. So for that, here I am declaring int j equal to 0. Okay, and here if this true condition is true, then what I will do, arr j plus plus. Okay, so I am from the 0th position, I am storing that index arr I, that array means that object. Okay, so in arr array only I am storing from ith position, means whenever it will match this condition, so this object I will store in the first index of this array. Okay, from arr j. Okay, and once this loop will end, what I will check, if j equal to 0, that means there is no match occurred. Okay, so no match occurred. So for the, if this scenario came, then I will print, this scenario comes, then I will print no criteria match. Okay, no criteria matched. Okay, and then I will terminate the code, means if there is no criteria match, then I will terminate. So for that, system.exist, system dot exist, and I am giving 0 as a parameter. So it's, that means I will terminate this program. Okay, and if this is not this scenario, then what I will do, then I will store inventory. I am creating a new array. Okay, so I am creating a inventory, inventory array. Okay, giving the name as arr1 equal to new inventory, new inventory, and size of this array would be the size of j. Okay, because I means if there is any matched condition, then means how many matched condition is there, so accordingly I will create a new array. Okay, and for that what I will do, from error I will store those values for int I equal to 0, I less than j, okay, and I plus plus. What I will do, I will means store all the element from error I to error 1, error to error 1. So error 1 I to error I, from error I will store all these element, or I will just copied all the element from error to error 1. Okay, and I will return this error 1, because in this error all the matched values are present. So error 1 I am returning, return error 1. Okay, so this is done, this method, implementation of this method is done. Now in the main method, so here inside the result I got the array, okay, means my required array. And then what I will do, I will print, okay, print the result here. So here you can see in the question, here you can see method should display the ID and return object. Okay, this method should be called from the main method and display the ID of the returned object along with the filling status. Okay, and filling status is, if the threshold is greater than or equal to 75, then it should print critical filling as filling status. If the threshold is between 74 to 50, filling status should be moderate filling, else should be non-critical filling. Okay, so here I am writing the logic for that. For int, okay, I equal to 0, I less than result dot length, because inside the result I sent the array, so the length of the array I will means execute this loop till the length of the array. Okay, so length of the array and I plus plus. Okay, so how many times this loop will execute means the size of the layer, size of the result array. Okay, and here I will check if result I, if result I dot get threshold, result I dot get threshold, if it is greater than equal to 75, okay, then what I will print, then I will print the result I dot inventory ID, because I have to print inventory ID. Okay, so then I will print result I dot get inventory ID, get inventory ID, and then I will print along with ID, I will print the status. So if it's greater than, then it is critical filling, critical line, critical filling. Okay, so this, and in the next part, in the next part what I will do, I will write else if. Okay, here I will write else if, else if result I dot get, if it's greater than 50, if it's greater than 50, then I will print, then I will print the moderate filling. Okay, so I will change here only moderate, moderate filling. Okay, and and the if else I will print, else I will print. So remove this part. Else I will print its non-critical fields. Okay, so here non-critical fields. Okay, so this is the code. So it's done. Okay, so now it's done. So now I will run this code. Okay, so if I run this code here, and here you can see I am giving the same input whatever is here. So here you can see it's 150 50. Okay, inventory is 1, then it's 100, then it's 50, it's also 50 threshold value. Then the inventory is 2, then max quantity is 260 40 260 40. Okay, 260 40, then inventory is 3 150 3 150, then it's 35 and 45 35 and 45, then it's 4 480 40 by 40, then it's 4 8 is the max quantity, 45, and then it's 40 is the threshold is 40, and then giving the output means limit is 45. Okay, so then giving 45 in means okay, sorry. How many input I have given? 1 minute. 150 50 2 260 40 3 4. Okay, so given the 5 next quantity, suppose 45. Threshold is 40. Okay. Oh, 1 minute. Oh, sorry. Where I have given. Yes. It should be less than 4. It should be 4. Okay. It should be 4. But I less than equal to 4. Okay. Because the size of the array is given wrong. So it would be less than 4. Okay, so now if you run, okay, so it's 1, then it's 150 50 50, 1, then 100, then 50, then again 50, then 2. Okay, 2 260 40, 2, then 200, then 60, then 40. Okay, then inventory ID is 3. Okay, 3 150 35 3 150 3 150 35 40 45. Then 4, max quantity is 80 45 40, and limit is 45. So if you give, then you can see output should be 2 3 and 4 non-critical fillings, 2 3 and 4. Okay, so if you see here 2 3 4, so 2 here the threshold is 40. Okay, so if it's less than equal to 50, so that's mean it will non-critical fillings 2. Then 3, for 3 it's also threshold is 45, so it's less than 50. Okay, and for 3, and for 4 also the threshold is 40, means less than 50. So these 3 came, and 1 is for 1, because one it's not included here, for one it's threshold is 50. So as per the question, if you see what should be the should be in output, if the threshold is greater than 60 before calling the method, should call from the main method. Threshold attribute is less than or equal to the int parameter passed, method will return the array of inventory where the threshold attribute is less than or equal. Okay, so it should be less than or equal. So for one, you can see threshold value is 50. So that's why, and I have provided here limit is 45. So it's greater than 50, so it will not include. It should be either less than or equal. Okay, less than or equal to 45. So accordingly, it will print the ID, okay, inventory ID and the filling status. Okay, so I'm showing the full code once again. So here is your main method. Okay, inside the solution class, here is the main method. So inside the main method, I write a for loop that will execute 4 times and it will take the 4 parameters. Okay, from console. Okay, values of this parameter like the inventory IDs, maximum quantity, enter current quantity and the threshold values. Okay, and it will create 4 inventory object and stored in the ARR array. Okay, this is the type of inventory. Okay, then I am provide one limit values. Okay, and I call the replenish, this replenish method, and here you can see the method implementation. So inside this method, I will check the if the threshold value is less than equal to limit. Okay, then I am storing those values into the same array from the index 0. Okay, from the same array means the inventory array what I have passed to this method. So in the same array I stored the value, matching value from the index zeros. Okay, index zeros, and outside this loop, so it will means I passed 4 values, 4 inventory object, so that is why this loop will execute 4 times. Okay, so and after that I am checking if j equal to 0, that means there is no matching criteria, then I will terminate the code forcefully by system calling system.exit. Okay, and here you can see the from the array 1 array 0 I am copying all the values object inventory object to ARR 1. Okay, so these are the matched object, and I am returning this array to main method. Okay, and inside the main method I stored that array, whatever when the method is return, so I stored that value into the result on result inventory array, and here I am printing the array element. Okay, the calling the get ID, get inventory ID and the filling status, and check here the condition that if threshold is greater than 75, then I will print the IDs and the status, filling status. Okay, and here is the inventory class. So inside the inventory class there is a 4 variables: inventory ID, maximum quantity, current quantity and threshold. Okay, and I provide the setter and getter methods for all the variables. Okay, all the attributes, and here you can see the constructor. Okay, inventory, it will take the 4 values or 4 fields. Okay, and it will set all the values and will create a constructor. Okay, so this is the whole code. Okay, so hope you guys are understood, and also subscribe my channel to get notification. Okay, and also click on the bell button inside the subscribe button, beside the subscribe button, so you will get the notification once I upload the new videos. Okay, so thanks for watching this video.